Enjoy up to 130,000 naira in bonuses on your first deposit when you register on PariPesa with our promo code FANSTRIBE. All right, 4-1 the result, and at the point it was looking like Chelsea was actually playing good football, and today will not be an embarrassment, but that's what it is, an embarrassment. How you see the match?
First of all, I want to say a huge congratulations to Man U fans, right? As a rival Chelsea fan, I'm very honest. I'm first of all, I'm a football fan before I'm a Chelsea fan. I'm very honest when I see a good performance. Man U did well. They had a game plan and they executed it perfectly well, which was sit back, soak the pressure, and counter-attack Chelsea. So congrats to Man U on their Champions League qualification. I'm happy for them. But my God, Frank Lampard. How is Frank Lampard the manager of Chelsea Football Club? It is, people laugh about it, but I think there's actually politics going on underneath this whole football system, because there's no other reason why Lampard should be Chelsea manager apart from political reasons. I can't see. As a matter of fact, I will take it further. There's no reason why Lampard should be a coach of any Premier League team. At best, relegation team. How on earth is Lampard? I was so surprised with first of all, the lineup. I'm not a fan that complains about coaching decisions too much, because I feel like you are the professional, you know what you're doing. So, but how on earth is Thiago Silva not in that team? No Koulibaly. How are we starting Chalobah and what's his name? Fofana. That, by the way, Fofana had an atrocious game. Dreadful. Wasteful game. I mean, Fofana should go and sit down. Maybe he should refund Chelsea 40 million back upon his money they gave to him. Refund about 40 million back. That was a waste. A hilarious. At a point, I almost laughed.
And the fact saying that Chalobah and Fofana now be the, come closer, smaller, be the possible future of Chelsea defense. How scary they said and did this back.
God forbid. Any Chelsea fan out there, I reject it for you. Chalobah and Fofana is not Chelsea's future. They are part of it, yes. Maybe as squad players. I don't think Fofana, I can understand, because I think maybe I might be overreacting because it's just one performance. So Fofana, I understand it might have that potential to get there. But Chalobah is not good enough. Let's call it spade a spade. Chalobah at best is a squad player. Maybe for rotation, but it's not. You tell yourself truth now. Do you see Chalobah as a Chelsea starter? Whether now, future, present, past, continuous, it's not. So why is he starting Chalobah and Fofana? So I don't think, for that one, I don't have any fear. Chalobah is not our future. Hell no.
And Mudrik now, definitely now Chelsea future be that. And with the body language, with the way in they do, like say, oh boy, guy, I don't mess up. Wait till they play, I don't understand. Clean post, you know, if he touch the ball, in the miss chances, in the lose the ball. And guy, I don't know, how you feel say this boy if he come back to that player where Chelsea go pay for?
First of all, I would say that Chelsea, if I'm being very honest, we missed it in the Modric purchase. I would say, not because I don't agree that Modric is a generational talent, I agree, he's a wonderful talent. But I think we were carried away by the fact that everybody wanted him and we didn't do our background check. Because I think Modric's problem today, some of us are very conversant with social media. He had a scandal going on now about the whole gym post he did and then. So maybe that's probably affecting his mind a little bit. So because today, you can clearly see Modric was not, his mind was not there, he was just lost. So, but I know that in the future, Modric definitely is going to be a world talent, that's for sure. If he puts his head down, works out, does the right things, Modric is a talent. I don't have fear, it's just one game. And by the way, let's also understand that this game was not of great significance to Chelsea. It was just for bragging rights and all that.
But the reverse of the case for Man U, because they need them to secure.
So I was not surprised to see Man U win. And so let's call it, let's not get carried away by, the score is poor, 4-1. But at the same time, it could be worse, because the chances, at the second half, Maya loved chances, so it could be worse. So we should be grateful that it's not a 7-0 like Liverpool gave to Maya earlier this season. So
interesting. And I'll be asking the other guy, and I'll ask you the same question. With how many chances Chelsea missed today, and how many points where they go cross ball, the person where the ball go meet, nobody finish the ball. And with Lukaku now coming back to the club, if you say maybe Pochettino feed use him as an option or maybe the guy to finish those chances. Because maybe the first time a club could just say, oh yeah, waiting, not happen. You don't pass. Can't play football now. And do you think Lukaku can maybe proceed for Chelsea?
Yeah, rightfully so. You made a very good point that Chelsea had a very good first half. This game was a game of two halves. First half, Chelsea totally dominated Man U. That's the truth. In almost all the starts, as a matter of fact, most of the first half, over two-thirds of the first half was played in Man U's half. That's the bitter truth. Just unfortunate that Chelsea could not score. So, to your point, which is a striker that can score those goals, personally, I don't think Lukaku should be accepted back in Chelsea. Just go for another loan.
They make mistake now. We all deserve a second chance. Yeah, imagine Xhaka waiting into and at least he come back, yes. Play ball. That one don't pass.
Yes, I'll tell you why. And my reason is not based on vendetta or spite towards him. No, like you said, people move on. Yeah. My reason is because Lukaku does not fit into this Chelsea team. The way we play, we need an Harry Kane. We don't need a striker that will sit down and wait for ball. That's Lukaku's pattern. He sits at the front, waits for football. They pass to him and then he scores. We need a striker that will be involved in the play, like a Benzema, yeah. like a Harry Kane, you know. We don't need a striker that will wait for ball. That's what Lukaku is. So, outside the misbehavior he had, it's not the profile of striker that Chelsea needs. If he comes again, trust me, he will flop again for the third time. So, please, going back to Lukaku and trying to match a relationship that will not work, why don't I just go straight? Now that Pochettino is coming to Chelsea, I believe we have a very strong influence in bringing Harry Kane. Yeah, because they work together. So go for it. Go all in and leave Lukaku alone. Probably go for another loan or sell him or something. Or if left for me, terminate his contract. Honestly. But
may everybody go there.
Yeah, but I know it's not realistic because it costs a lot of money. Yeah, but see Ronaldo. Mario just said, let's go our way. And Ronaldo is doing fine where he is. Mario is doing fine where they are. Everybody's happy. So that's my take.
Your final thought on Chelsea season and they're moving forward to next season?
Yeah, final thoughts. I think this is not the end for Chelsea. I know rivals are laughing at Chelsea. We're laughing at us now. Hey, they are down. Let me correct one impression. Chelsea is not going to become Aston Villa or Southampton or one. No. Chelsea is still a very, very big club. So if you're happy and laughing at our downfall, that means you don't know football. If you know football, you know Chelsea next season or maybe season after that definitely will bounce back. So it has been a very, very, I would say, if I want to put it in one word, horrific season, should be told.
The earlier it ends, the better.
Yeah, we can't wait. I believe every Chelsea fan will agree with me and say we cannot wait for this season to end. But trust me, the pain and the wounds, the scars of this season is what will drive us to hit next season hard. And I believe it. And by the way, please, a lot of players need to go. All these Galaga, these guys are below, the fact they are below average. They should go. If I should count players in Chelsea now that are world-class material, not world-class yet, but world-class material, they're not more than 15. And we have over 40 people. What are they doing? You should go.
My church. Todd Bowley won't open church. No, Allah, bro. Thank you so much. Football fans tribe over here with the interview Niger football fans. After matches, I will give you Niger football fan content back to back. So if you're new, please click that subscribe button. And I beg, help us like this video. Thank you so much for watching. Thanks for watching. Right here, another one of our videos where you're supposed to like all our social media links. I beg, follow us on every platform because we get content for everybody.